The focus of my lab is how can we bring technology to improve people's lives and amplify human potential.
Intel Labs is an epicenter of future technology exploration. The Intelligent Systems Research Team at Intel Labs focuses on humans and artificial intelligence working together. Lama Nachman leads this team. Her journey from humble beginnings to Intel Fellow informs her passion and is evident in how her team builds Wonderful.
When I was a child in Kuwait, you know, as I was kind of progressing through the different grades, I knew that I liked science and math. All I remember is I was so much into high tech, the latest and greatest thing. Constantly trying to break these things apart, figure out how they work, put them back together. Sometimes they work, sometimes they don't. The logical choice was, okay, well, it sounds like engineering might be the thing for me. Like constantly analyzing all this new technology and trying to think about where are the gaps in these technologies and how can they best support human needs. And now 40 years later, that's exactly what I'm doing. So in retrospect, it's actually kind of funny. Imagine, you know, someone who can't type, for example. Today, it's kind of a given that you can actually speak to your computer and your computer can do things for you. Think about people who can't speak and who can't actually physically type. How do we bring an ability where someone can use a very, very tiny signal? Imagine somebody moving an eyebrow, slightly moving a finger, moving a cheek, like in the case of Professor Stephen Hawking. That's all you could do. So ACAT was really meant to take a very tiny signal that somebody can express and turn it into a way to be able to totally control your PC in the same way that you and I do.
The Assistive Context Aware Toolkit, or ACAT, is an open source platform developed by researchers at Intel Labs to help people with limited mobility communicate and interact with their computer. Originally created for Stephen Hawking, ACAT was developed to be modifiable. This configurability can accommodate users with a wide range of disabilities. It also enables users to perform common tasks.
What we're really trying to do is bring the underlying capability of response generation systems and allow them to actually control that response generation system based on what they need in the moment. So you could imagine a user who wants total control over the conversation, right? They want to be able to spell out every single thing and they have a very specific way of expressing themselves. Then the system can, you know, take less agency. The response could be, you know, much more controlled by the user. On the other end of the spectrum, you could imagine maybe chit-chatting with some friends. And what you care about is for your response to come quickly. And there, the system will be listening to that conversation and highlighting different things based on what most people would say and what it has heard you say before. So then the person can just simply select one of a few options. And as a result, the response will come out very quickly. So we're bridging that silence gap. A lot of these platforms are very hard to build because they can't leverage the economies of scale, right? If you think about your phone, well, there are billions of users that use phones. So you can leverage the technology development towards that. For people with disability, it's small populations with very specific needs. So it's very hard to build a solution from scratch and still make it accessible to people. Our vision for ACAT was, can we create an open source platform that allows anybody to innovate? So now instead of spending 3 years developing a platform, then to be able to interface to somebody with a specific disability, you have that platform and you can then customize it with a specific sensor, which could take a day or two. One area that we've been thinking about quite a bit and doing a lot of research in, including in schoolrooms, is how do you measure student engagement and how can you utilize student engagement to help teachers support the specific and personalized needs of the different students?
When you think about the current educational systems, we keep time constant and expect all children to meet the same learning outcomes at the same time. But they have different learning abilities, needs, and characteristics.
I think at the end of the day, there's so much to learn and so little time. So the questions are, can you make learning more effective? Can you make learning more engaging? And third, can you make learning more efficient? This is exactly where AI can come in. Sometimes students are having amazing conversations. They're excited about ideas, but it's not on the radar of the instructor. So if there's a possibility in which AI can somehow sift through and synthesize what's occurring and then feed that information back to the instructor, that can be used to develop more effective whole class discussions on topics that students are really excited and engaging about. When we think about students deciding the future of how they want AI to develop, one of the things we do, we actually put these questions to students to have them negotiate and think about some of these complicated decisions, and that gives us insights into how to design to give the students the maximum flexibility in what they're comfortable with. One exciting technology is our intelligent tutoring systems. These are systems that aim to emulate human tutors. So we know that human tutoring is one of the most effective ways people learn, one-on-one tutoring. Can you actually build computer tutors that embody some aspects of human tutoring?
Learning outcomes correlate very well with student engagement. We've done a lot of ethnographic research with parents, with teachers, to try to understand where are the gaps and what are the unmet needs in this space. And one thing that a lot of our ethnographic research was pointing to is that parents really love the idea of being able to utilize advancement in technology to help in their kids' learning. They don't want their kids to fall behind, but they're terrified of screen time.
I was approached about 3 years ago from my assistant superintendent, who said, I have a proposal for you. I was invited to learn and hear about this kids space project with Intel. It was a partnership with Intel where they needed a space to operate a prototype.
From research, we know that personalizing learning experiences makes a big difference. If you think about the class sizes and teacher-student ratios, right? How can one teacher personalize learning experiences for 30 individual students? It's not scalable. But from research, we also know that like one-on-one tutoring creates a huge impact in educational outcomes. So with KidSpace, we kind of try to address that, and we position Oscar as a peer learner in the space. Oscar is a conversational agent, which is like empowered by context-aware multimodal AI technologies. So it was a user-centered design that we have done, you know, together with teachers. And this really helped us understand like their perspective, and we leveraged their perspective in our design and development activities.
Hello, my name is Oscar. Look, my beautiful garden.
So our first prototype was not perfect, of course. Oscar is like a video game character, right? A teddy bear. And who doesn't like a teddy bear?
I sat in on a session where students were interacting with the program. They were so engaged and excited to be working with Oscar. Such enthusiasm just bubbled up. They were talkative, they were interacting with each other, smiling, laughing, talking about it even after the session was over, all the way down the hall, telling their friends about it.
If you look at current conversational systems, they purely based on speech as a modality. To enable Oscar to do all of these different things, we need multimodal inputs. There is a lot of complex technologies running in the background to enable Oscar to understand what kids are saying, you know, in the space, or what they are doing in the space, so that it can craft the interactions accordingly. So that's why we call it as context aware.
KidSpace can turn any classroom into an interactive learning experience. The main components are cameras for pose, gesture, and object tracking, LiDAR for wall touch detection, an overhead projector for displaying a 3D scene, and microphones for audio detection. With all the complexity of this immersive system, still, many components are off the shelf. This physical and digital hybrid experience is uniquely managed through a real-time operating system architecture and multiple AI algorithms working together. Kitspace is built on Intel i7 and i9 processors to compute vast amounts of contextual data. Through the innovations of researchers and their partners in education, this system is not simply about what ingredients Intel makes, but what Intel makes possible.
We can't go back to how it was before. This is the new normal. However, we need to recognize that in education, we don't have the experience and the training and tools to be developing these technologies. We need to be partnering with our information technology partners in order to construct these opportunities for our teachers and our students. I also appreciate your desire to take some of that load off of our teachers so that they can focus on building that relationship so that they can better advocate for our students in our school. So thank you. Bam!
There's a project that we've been working on called MERI. The idea of MERI is to actually look at how can AI come into manufacturing settings to really support humans in performing tasks. And if you bring the AI and the human together, that you end up with a much better solution than either of them alone.
There are complexity in the world that we live in that cannot be solved by AI alone. And they will need the continuous and constant and efficient input from the human to really learn over time what is the best way to perform a task or to execute an activity. There is a cognitive load in performing those activities, and AI can help the human performing those activities. The problem is data annotation is actually one of the main bottlenecks of AI. And so what we want to do with a human AI collaboration system is also to enable a much more easy way to annotate the data in real time. We use natural language processing to have a dialogue with the user while he's interacting with the system. As things change in the manufacturing process because it's been improved, the AI will pick up those signals by an interaction with the user. For example, the user can narrate what he's doing. The AI system, if, for example, there is confusion in the detection, in the inference, can ask the user, what are you doing now? Are you doing action A or action B? We are not looking at systems that are being trained on data and then deployed, and then hopefully all goes well. It is a system that will learn with the user over time.
Application of machine learning and artificial intelligence in manufacturing environment is important. Because it is going to ensure that we are having better products that are hitting the final customer. In terms of quality, in terms of performance, you have extremely sharp kind of learning curve because you have the system to guide you and help you every step along the way.
Project MERI uses natural language processing and advanced analytics to support the performance of technicians in a manufacturing environment. The system incorporates fixed cameras, RFID tags and readers, inertial measurement units, along with audio and other environmental sensors, and leverages all the data provided through these multimodal inputs to infer relevant information about the task being performed and to interact with the human in the shared workspace.
The goal of this project is not to fully eliminate people, humans, from the factory floor. It's more a kind of a collaborative effort. Is alleviating a certain amount of stress from the operators that are performing those tasks. If I have a system that can track what I'm doing and potentially correct me, then I'm not going to be as stressed.
When the project is complete, I'm expecting that a novice user goes to the workbench not knowing what they need to do and basically being taught what are the next steps.
You know, often we talk about the business value that AI brings in its application and solutions. But beyond that is the positive effect it has on our employees and workforce. AI solutions that we're deploying allows us to offload a lot of the tedious nature of data analysis, so our engineers can really focus on what's important and free them up to do more creative tasks and solve problems that AI solutions can't.
I think this notion that AI is on this trajectory that we can't do anything about, I actually think is actually quite silly. And in some sense, it distracts from the opportunities of what we can do about it and from where the harms might come from. I worry about how do we develop responsible AI today that isn't marginalizing people, that isn't using people's data in ways that it shouldn't, that isn't biased, you know, and discriminating against different populations. Those are real problems today that we, as developers of AI systems, can do something about. One of the reasons why I think human AI collaboration brings a lot of promise is that we can start to really think about how do these systems coexist and how do they collaborate in a way that they can bring the best of both of these together. And how do we do that responsibly? The only way that you could do that, in my opinion, is by bringing the right voices to the table, by really spanning tons of different disciplines. You have to start to really thinking about a lot of the ethics and psychology and social science coming together with a lot of the computer science aspect of this research to try to build that future that we all want.
From making technology more inclusive, to making education more immersive, to making manufacturing more efficient, these are just a few of the ways that the Intelligent Systems Research Team at Intel Labs does its part to create world-changing technology that improves the life of every person on the planet.